My name is Gabriel Payton. I'm a graduate of ASN 2015.
Why is this day important to you?
Well, this is important because this is basically my second chance at life, because I didn't get a chance to pass high school like I wanted to, so that kind of went down the drain. So the GED was basically my second to going up in life.
What was the most difficult thing about getting to this point in your life?
Probably just the motivation, because I was out of school for a while and just sitting at home kind of stuck like a routine. So I just wasn't motivated enough to do it. But once I came here, saw how it was, it gave me more than enough motivation to do it.
What role have alternative schools played in getting up to this point?
And they played a lot in getting me to this point. They helped me through everything. They supported me. They helped me out. They helped me learn it. And they got me there. I went in, did it, and I came out, successful.
Why is education important to you?
Education is important to me because it's basically, for me, it's the best way to achieve anything in life. Because the more you learn, the more you earn. And the more knowledge you have, the better person you'll be.
What are your plans for the future?
I just want to go out and experience new skills that I can use for the rest of my life. Just, get in whatever seems fun to me.
Where do you see yourself in 5 to 10 years?
About 5 years, I see myself either working IT in a major company or working as a manager in a manufacturing company. In about 10 years, I'm probably seeing owning my own company for probably both IT and manufacturing.
What is your favorite thing about today?
That's kind of hard to pick. It's just a really great day for me. So I would probably say everything.
Anything else like that?
ASN is the place to be.
My name is Sierra Pickens. I'm 19, and I'm graduating from ASN Prep Institute.
Why is this day important to you?
This day is important to me because it's a new beginning to another level in my life.
What was the most difficult thing about getting to this point in your life?
I had 2 tragedies in the family. I lost my father, Torrance Pickens, October 6, 2014, to gun violence, and then I turned around and lost my grandmother on June 29th, 2015.
What role have alternative schools played in getting you to this point?
Alternative schools have changed my life. They helped me. They gave me another chance to get on the right track and to get my diploma and move on to the next level in my life.
Why is education important to you?
Education is important to me because that's the key out. That's the way out. It's only 2 ways out, and it's only 2 routes, the good route or the bad route. It's either you're going to be on the streets and get your money, or you're going to go to school and have a professional job and get your money. And I feel like I chose my way. I chose my way. I don't want to go to school. I plan on being a registered nurse and getting this money and taking my family away from everything that we've been through.
Where do you see yourself in 5 to 10 years?
In 5 to 10 years, I see myself as a registered nurse, a charge nurse, running a whole hospital.
What is your favorite thing about today?
It's a ceremony of I accomplished something. I feel as if I accomplished something and I made my parent proud. I feel like my daddy legacy lives on within me. And this is my moment.
So. Is there anything else you'd like to say?
ASN Prep really changed my life. The teachers and mentors here really are straightforward, on point, and they really care about you. So I recommend anybody who don't have a GED or high school diploma to come to this program.
Good afternoon to our parents, students, faculty, staff, and our special guests. Welcome to the Alternative School Network, better known as ASN Preparatory Institute, 2015 commencement exercise. I am Pamela Jeffers, one of the GED instructors here at ASN. It is such an honor and a privilege to stand before you to introduce to you a very unique class of wonderful, fantastic, phenomenal, intellectual, and articulate men and women. I have witnessed this ASN GED class diligently work hard, come to our after-school hours of tutoring. I saw the many tears of frustration and some disappointments, but through it all, they are mighty and triumphant. Persevered through some failed attempts of exams and pushing through one of the coldest days of the year where we in Chicago experienced negative 38 degrees temperature. Without any further delay, we will start this exercise. Graduate. Please stand as we sing our national anthem, Lift Every Voice. I'm sorry. The graduates are coming forth. Please come. Okay, can everyone please stand now as we do, lift every voice and sing our national anthem.
See you.
may be seated. The next person we will have is our salutatorian. She's a trooper, a young lady with a very bright future, a future as a head nurse. She has direction and purpose. I watched her blossom into a beautiful flower. She is not a stranger to hard work. Miss Sierra Pickens.
Family, friends, staff, and to the class of 2015. I would like to welcome you to not the end, but to the beginning of a new chapter in our lives. This last past year has been one of the most challenging years of my life. I lost my father, Torrance Pickens, October 6, 2014, to gun violence. When I lost my father, that devastated me to my core. I was so hurt, lost, and I had no sense of direction. I kept asking myself, what am I gonna do now? What am I gonna do now? Then suddenly, everything my father taught me came in my head at once, and at that moment, I felt like I was him. My father was so insistent on me finishing school that I knew what I had to do. Coincidentally, my younger sister and one of my fellow classmates, Demonte Bailey's younger brother, were former classmates. And our mother shared the same devastation to losing someone close to them to gun violence. Demonte's mother told me about this program, and I immediately jumped on top of it. That same evening, I spoke with Ms. Franklin, and from that moment, it changed my life forever. While I attended ASN prep, I had one-on-ones with my teachers and mentors. They were so loving, on point, supportive, and straightforward. Everything was going great until another twist. On June 29th, 2015, I lost my grandmother. And I was back at point A again. When I lost my grandmother, I ain't come to school for 2 weeks. My mentor Jacob was on my heels like my ankles. Then here when I returned to school, Miss Hardy like, Miss Sierra, if you would have missed one more day, I would have been knocking at your door. Not only were these my mentor fellow classmates and teachers, they became a part of my extended family. The staff at ASN Prep knew the importance of me getting my credentials, and they seen my potential, so they pushed me to my full extent. They kept me in place when I got a little discouraged. They encouraged me. They were real supportive. I'm going to leave you with these words of wisdom. I could sum up life in 3 words. Life goes on. Time waits for no one, and it's your choice. It's now or never. So with that being said, I am honored to be the salutatorian of the class of 2015, and I will ask that all my fellow graduates please stand and pay homage to those who made this moment possible.
Thank you, Sierra. That was wonderful. Now, I would like to introduce you to an incredible, gifted, and talented young lady who achieved her GED with honors. Upon completing her GED, she was immediately accepted to Chicago State University on a summer scholarship. Not only did she receive a scholarship, but she was just accepted to Chicago State's honors program yesterday. This lovely lady is no other than Shaquita Smith. Please come forward.
Martin Luther King says, The ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands of times of challenge and controversy. I believe I speak for all when I say being given a second chance at our educational careers and dominating the chance demonstrates where we will stand after today. We came to ASN Prep because of multiple causes, but today we are gathered here due to one effect. It's an honor to represent my fellow classmates because I know the fight wasn't easy. We're standing on the precipice of our future. This may be a simple bridge for most, but to us, it's a connection to a new life. Through the tears, the disappointments, and long afternoons with Ms. Smith, I can say this jubilation that I'm experiencing is all worth it. To my classmates, we met on different circumstances, and then I want you to know that this was destiny. I know it's tough to look at what society has labeled as success, but guess what? You weren't built to be the norm. Life only gets better from here on out. We have the opportunity right now to grasp life and own it. If you're ever at a hard time in your life, look back at this moment. Remember what you're feeling at this moment. You didn't give up. You kept pushing, and you succeeded. Getting out of bed, having the stats for raps, passing those tests, that was all you. It takes a special breed of young people to stay self-motivated through life's obstacles. Be proud of yourself. In fact, I couldn't complete this task without the encouragement from you guys. You welcomed me with open arms and reminded me that I wasn't alone in my situation. For that, I am grateful, and I pray nothing but success for you all. To the staff of ASN Prep, I know upon your arrival, you assigned the mentor, but all of you guys motivate and encourage every student. My first day, I remember about the dedication of the staff. I've never seen such excitement about a career come from a host of adults. I know it's not easy, but again, I think I speak for everybody when I say thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for all the personal time, staying on us regardless of what, and breaking this test down to a science. A special thanks is owed to Ms. Franklin for putting together such a devoted team to handle this delicate time of our lives. Gratitude can never be expressed in words. Last but not least, to my friends and my family. There is so much I can say, but there isn't enough time. Some of you guys have stayed by my side and never once judged my situation. Because of that, I am filled with joy and appreciation. As I continue my journey, I will hold each and every one of you near to my heart. To my mother, thank you for the tough love. You've always told me to be strong and always be a better me. I thank God, even with trials and tribulation, that I was blessed into your care. I can say that I was not proud about achieving my GED. After years of trying and being defeated, I was emotionally beat. Along with the complications of having a pacemaker and being ashamed of my educational disruptions, I just did not feel good about myself. Despite those thoughts, I came to ASN Prep and I conquered. I passed those tests and sung with honors. I am proud to say I have embarked upon my new journey. I will be attending Chicago State University this fall. I had the opportunity to receive a free class this summer and am happy to report that I completed the class with a 98%. Thank you. I also tested out of math, so I will receive proficiency credit. I will be entering my first semester with 6 free credits and a 4.0 GPA. I will receive a merit scholarship, and I am a prospective candidate for the University of Chicago's Honors College due to my ACT score of a 23. I am more than grateful, and it's bittersweet to leave you guys. I don't think I could express how much of a life-changing experience ASN Prep has provided me. I genuinely love you guys. This is not a farewell. This is a see you later. Let's be honest, I can't stay away from you guys, your family. Thank you.
Thank you, Chiquita. That was beautiful. The next graduate is a young man who amazed me with his gift of technology. He debugged my phone as well as my laptop. And I'm so grateful. Gabriel Patton, please come up.
Good evening, everybody. I will be showing you who your speaker is today, but before I do that, I would like to say something. I'm very happy and very proud to be here today. I'm sure, just like the rest of my fellow graduates, we are all also very appreciative and grateful for everybody that's here that's been supporting us. It may not seem like it, but it was not an easy road getting here. As of last year, about around the same time, I believe is the time that I joined ASN, and I'm thinking to myself, like, I'm gonna try this, see what I can do, see how far I can get. So as I did this, they were just so very supportive of me. They believed in me that I can do it, and believing in me, they made me believe in myself. So I went in, and then 6 to 8 months later, I did everything. Got my GED, and I went on my way. But I don't want to say it like I didn't want to stay here, believe me. This is a great place to be, and I'm always going to be very, very grateful and appreciative for what they've done to me. I'm always going to be very grateful and appreciative to my family for supporting me. I'm sure you all will be very happy and proud of your graduates as well. But without further ado, let me begin. This man, he began his career as a stand-up comedian in the mid-1990s, also known as the Destin Legend. He is a comedian who has toured the country and abroad. He has been featured on several popular comedy shows, including Showtime at the Apollo, a four-week winner, BET's Comic View, BET's One Mic Stand, P. Diddy's Bad Boys of Comedy, Jamie Foxx's Laugh-A-Palooza, Cedric the Entertainer's Starting Lineup, and Bill Bellamy's Who's Got Jokes. In 2008, he was selected as a spokesperson for the EA Sports video game Madden NFL 2009. His sports fever was also heard on the airwaves back in 2005 during his two-year stint as a co-host of the sports talk radio show, Sports Unplugged. With ESPN writer Scoop Jackson and college basketball analyst Steve Bardo, he is a steadfast mentor in the city of Chicago, speaking to numerous students, adults, and organizations. He is firmly entrenched in his community and is currently a WGCI radio personality. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Leon Rogers.
Wow, man, I didn't know I did all that stuff right there. I'm gonna have to have them look at that again. I know I did all that. How's everybody doing today? How's everybody doing today, man? It's the problem with our community. We don't speak to each other no more. What happened to good morning? How you doing? I'm speaking to you. I didn't wake up with none of y'all this morning. Don't be mad at me. Today is a great day, man. We're honoring these young ladies and gentlemen for doing something that a lot of people think is easy. I want y'all to listen to this right now, because we've all been through high school. And sometimes it's not easy. You know, before we used to always look at students and say, well, why aren't they doing this? And why aren't they doing that? Not realizing that their outside lives affect what they do in school. Now that I've gotten older and I've mentored at schools and I've had young men come up to me and say, and I ask them, hey man, why have you missed 25 days or 30 days of school? You know, your teachers told me you missed school. Well, man, Mr. Rogers, I ain't been staying at home. Why you not staying at home? You get evicted? What's going on? Talk to me. Well, I actually had a student tell me one day that his father was in a different gang that he was in, and he told him if he caught him at the crib, he was gonna have the shorties whoop him. I said to myself, how can I be mad at him? How can I literally look in his face and come down on him for not being at school, or because he's trying to go somewhere to get some rest? He can't be at home. So I commend you all for battling through and persevering through whatever was going on in your life, because it can be real easy to get sidetracked. I'm an adult. I've been working in radio now for 15 years. I've been at WGCI 10 years. It's easy for me to get sidetracked. I start thinking about bills. I start thinking about this. My job suffers. So for what you've done, for what you've gone through, I commend you for that, because it's not easy. Everybody will sit and look and say, some people are sitting like, all they do it, all you gotta do is go to high school. All you gotta do is sit down and learn and read. It's tough out here, especially for you guys. You're growing up in a different era from what I grew up in, from what some of you all grew up in. You have a lot to worry about going back and forth to school. So one thing I want to address to you now, and I'm talking to you guys, is I want you to remember these three words: pay it forward. It is your duty to pay it forward. Everything that you've went through, everything that you've done, there's somebody else that's going to be coming behind you that's going through the same thing or even worse. It is your duty as a human being, as a child of God or whoever you believe in, to go to that person and tell them, hey, I've been there. I've been there. Sometimes mentorship and philanthropy is not all just about giving a whole bunch of money to stuff. Sometimes it's giving words of encouragement, a pat on the back. I'm here for you. So shout out to everybody that's in this building right now supporting them, because you're saying, we're here for you. We appreciate what you've done. Some people might have to go to work. We're not going to hold that against them. But at the end of the day, if you know you have a firm support unit behind you and people that you can turn to when you need to talk to, it makes the journey a lot easier. So I say to you all, pay it forward. From this end to this end, pay it forward. I see a lot of babies in the room today. Pay it forward to the next group so they can pay it forward to that group. Because your little brothers and sisters and nephews and cousins are coming up in the same world you're coming up in. And you've already got the tools to show people that you can persevere. We see that you can persevere. We see that you're determined. We see that you don't give up. Those are things that sometimes we're all kind of born with them, but sometimes they have to be brought out in us. So it was brought out in you, so help bring it out in somebody else. The second thing I want to say to you all is laugh. Laugh. Take time to laugh, man. Matter of fact, go through the whole gamut of emotions. Laugh, cry, because you're a guy. If you happy today about graduating from here, man, and you want to shed a tear, brother, you deserve it. You deserve it. Ladies, if you want to be like, I did that, go ahead and do it. I ain't gonna think less than you. Be proud like you did that. Go through your gamut of emotions. Just like when I came up here and said hello, and I got a half-hearted hello back, all that stuff needs to stop. We people, talk to each other. That's a whole part of it, communication. Going through those emotions. You happy about something, you're happy. You're angry about something, express that. Don't hold that stuff in, because then it comes out in the wrong way. And once again, it all goes back to affecting what you do. Some of you are going to go on to college. Some of you might go on to a trade school. Some of you all might join the armed forces. I didn't go to college. I graduated high school. There's a young lady I went to school with back here, Charlotte. What's up? We graduated together. I didn't go to college. It wasn't for me. Tried it. I was home within 2 weeks. 2 weeks. You turned me loose in Jackson, Mississippi, and nobody to get up in the morning and tell me to go to class. I sat at home and played video games every day till they finally just came in and said, oh, this ain't going to work. And my father was like, you need to come on back home. But then I went and did 8 years in the United States military. Best move I ever made in my life. It gave me discipline. It gave me structure. Now, that may not be for you. That may not be for you. That may not be for you. College may be your thing. Going to a trade school may be your thing. Starting your own business may be your thing. Only thing I'm telling you, the same perseverance and dedication that you attacked your GED with, attack the next level the same way. It gets a little tougher. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm not going to sugarcoat anything for you. It gets a little tougher now because you're an adult. Nobody's going to hold your hand. We can support you. We can say, great job, attaboy, but it's up to you. It's up to you. When you look in that mirror, you can do one or two things. You can give yourself the rah, rah, rah speech and not really mean it. Yeah, I'm going to get out and go get a job. I'm going to do this tomorrow. I'm going to go to school and do this. And the whole time, you spitting a rap song to somebody that ain't on the other side of that mirror, because that ain't you. You're selling yourself a dream. Or you could just say, hey, I'm going to do it. Nothing's going to stop me. And if I need help, I know who to go to and get help. Because it sounds like just from hearing the three of you talk that you all have established friendships and bonds with people that work here that you can always come back and talk to them. And the third thing I'm going to tell you this before I get out of here, because I feel this is the most important of all. Never let anybody else's success determine where you need to be in life. Don't do that. Don't ever put that pressure on yourself. I'm a stand-up comedian. If I woke up every morning and compared myself to Kevin Hart, I'd be done killed myself by now. Let's just be perfectly honest. Kevin Hart is doing a 36-city tour with no less than 30,000 people in each arena. Probably going to clear well over 100, 150 million through this tour. I'll be performing at Francis Lounge tomorrow night for $150. But you know what? I'm happy. I'm okay with what I'm doing. Not to discare. I'm not saying I'll turn that down if it was to happen. If he make the phone call, I'm on the next plane out of here. But I'm happy and okay with who I am and where I am as an individual and as a human being. And we get so caught up in trying to live the lives of people we see on TV, we don't really understand we're doing all right. See, when I grew up, I had a father and a mother. God bless, I lost my father 4 years ago to cancer, but him and my mother were married 43 years. So I had a blueprint of a man. A lot of young gentlemen don't have that today. They don't have it today. You know what I'm saying? That's why you guys got to be the new blueprint. You got a second chance. You're young. You got your GED. You can move around. You can do different things. Now, be the blueprint for that next young man. Don't have to be your son. Don't have to be your little brother. It could just be somebody in the neighborhood. You'd be surprised how many people look up to you and you don't know it. Females, the same way. You'd be surprised how many young girls like your swag, like what you do, and they want to follow and emulate everything you do. But we get so caught up in trying to live like the Jay-Z's, the Beyoncé's, and Jesus's of the world. Listen, I'm 44 years old, and I still, once every 3 months, I make a dream board. I get a piece of cardboard, and I cut out different things that I want in life, and I put it on the board. And I put it up in a room in my house. So when I come in, I see it all the time. And it motivates me. Now, I've been through 2 dream boards. I've knocked down 2 dream boards. Now I'm working on my third one. The third one, the goals get loftier and loftier. But what I'm saying is, it's all about pace. It's all about time. And what's destined for you is destined for you. Nobody can change that. That's going to happen. Now, you can delay it by BSing yourself and taking paths that lead you off the course. You'll always come back, though. For example, maybe I was supposed to be a millionaire at 30 years of age. But decisions that I made in my life took me off that path. So now I'm way over here. I'm supposed to be on 57. I'm on 94. By the little doo-doo mountain over there on 130th. Life stinks right now. I'm supposed to be on 57 getting off in Lincoln Highway right now and getting my million. But then I get my mind right. I get focused. I get my life right. I make my way back over to 57. I make my way back over. But now I'm 60. I get my millions, then I die at 64. What's for you is for you. It's gonna happen. It's gonna happen. You just gotta stay on course and stay focused. And you gotta attack everything like you attack this GED, the same perseverance. Say, it's not over. I know you feel relieved. You're like, whew, I made it. Ooh, this it. Nope. Here come a whole nother set of hurdles. Trust me. Not finna sugarcoat it. Here come a whole nother set of hurdles. But with your support group, with your trainer, so to speak, I like to compare everything to sports. I'm a sports guy. With your trainer, so to speak, with your other teammates, you can still be the captain. You can still be the Jordan of your team, but rely on your other teammates to help you get through this game and win a championship. And your championship doesn't determine what my championship is. If you go on to owe a towing company with 2 tow trucks and your mortgage is paid for, you got a car in the garage, you can send your babies to college, you can go buy what you want, you got a budget a little bit, that's cool. So what if he can go buy a $200,000 car? That's his comfort of success. If you want more, you'll go after that. But if you cool where you are and you're doing well and you ain't asking nobody for nothing, man, in this day and time, be happy with who you are and what you can do. Everybody ain't gonna be a millionaire. Everybody ain't gonna be a billionaire. If the world was that perfect, man, listen, we all be having this graduation ceremony in the Cayman Islands right now.
Everybody be in bikinis and swim trunks. Well, I know, you know, I've seen some of the guys in here, including myself. Y'all don't want to see us in no swim trunks, but I'm just saying. Put on a little scuba suit or something. There's only a few of us in here that look great, you know, in some swim trunks. But at the end of the day, at the end of the day, don't let anybody's success determine yours. And don't feel bad about what you're doing because you see what somebody else is doing. I never admired the dope dealer or whatever growing up. I never admired it. I looked at my dad. And when he wasn't around, it was I had a next door neighbor that lived next to me named Mr. Robinson. He worked for the CTA. Brother had a Benz, was single. I used to see him fly all the time. I used to be like, man, I want to be like him when I grow up. Well, I want to be like my dad. He wasn't no rap star. He wasn't no dope dealer. The man worked at the CTA and used to tell us, man, I drive a bus, but I make good money because I do my job and I do it well. So if I had a nickel for everybody to ask me, why you not in L.A. like your man D-Ray or like Corey Holcomb or like Lil Rel, which are all my friends, I go, it's not meant for me to be in L.A. It's meant for me to be on the radio, talking every morning, educating, informing, and entertaining. I feel like that's my job out here. It's meant for me to be here talking to you today, because if I was in L.A., I wouldn't be talking to you. So there's a reason I'm on the radio in Chicago, and I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. I got a lovely wife, three beautiful children. They cool. We don't want for nothing. I'm good. And if they fire me from the radio tomorrow, guess what? Then I got to go back to that same perseverance, determination, and grit that you all showed in even getting your GEDs. I got to revert back to that and get out here and get it. Whatever way I can to make sure my family eats. But as long as we okay, I'm okay. So remember, pay it forward, go through a gamut of emotions, and never let anybody else's success determine what's successful for you. Stay focused. God bless you. I will be shouting each and every one of y'all out on WGCI Monday morning because I think this is something that needs to be talked about. They talk about everything else in the city. But I don't see no news cameras in here reporting on this. And it's a beautiful thing. God bless you all. Thank you. I love you, boy. You can real quick.
Come on, let's give him another round of applause. Come on. Not every day you have a GCI personality here. Wow. Next, I'm going to ask all the mentors to come up as they do the presentation of diplomas. As the mentors are coming forth, I would like to introduce you to all of our ASN prep staff. Can you please stand? Here we have Josh Cohen. He is our GED instructor. He teaches language arts as well as social studies. We have Ms. Charlotte Smith. She is our job coach. She also works with the colleges and universities as we get our students ready for different trade programs as well as colleges. I am Ms. Jeffers. I am the GED instructor for science and math. We have Ms. Nina Harding. She is one of our mentors. We have Ms. Tamara Jemison. She is another one of our mentors. We have Jacob Carruthers III. He is another mentor. We have our wonderful director, Ms. Franklin. Let's give it up for Ms. Franklin. Yes. Mentors, are you ready? Can all the graduates please stand? DeMonte Bailey. Tawan Harper. Tawan Harper. Gabriel Payton. Sierra Pickens. Last but not least, Ayulani Stain. Yes.
Everyone, I'm Ms. Franklin, and I just want to take the opportunity to tell the graduates I am so proud of you all. I'm holding back tears as you are speaking and getting these diplomas because I know some of the challenges that you've had, and you all have persevered, and I applaud all of you. And just like it was said in one or more of your speeches, you all know that we are here for you. This doesn't end our relationship with this graduation. We will always be here for you, as you know already. I want to just take this opportunity to recognize anyone in the audience who is from ASN, our organization, our main office. Please stand. This is Erica Williams. Erica is our human resources specialist director. Anyone else here? I saw Keith was here, but Keith must have had to leave, Keith Thomas. But we appreciate all of your support, too. We couldn't do what we do if it was not for what you do to assist us. At this time, we're going to have the graduates to stand. And if you haven't already turned your tassels, please do. All right, and we're going to recess with our farewell song. If you want to stay in place for just a few minutes for the farewell song to start, and then we're going to have our recessional on the farewell song, where you will greet your guests that are here, and we will have a reception immediately following on the lower level of the building. I see Don is here. Thank you so much, Don. He did a lot to help us out to get ready for this. Okay, so I've just been informed that our guest speaker, Leon Rogers, is going to take pictures with you all. So just remain in the auditorium. You want to take those pictures on stage, Leon, or?
Wherever they want.
Okay, all right. I also want to thank the young man in the video booth, too, because he worked some special hours to come in and provide services for our graduation today. So, it's a hand for Kirk.
So my name is Leon Rogers. I work on 107.5 WGCI. I'm one-third of the Chicago Morning Takeover. You can catch us from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. And I basically came here to speak to the graduating students today of the ASN Preparatory Institute Class of 2015.
Why do you feel it's important for these young individuals to pursue their GED or high school diploma?
Well, for one, as a sign of hope, because let's be honest, in Chicago right now, it's a tough time, man, with everything that's going on, and especially with youth between the age of 13 to, let's just say, 18, 19, and even might be extending up into 22 and 23. They're like an endangered species, male and female. So to get your GED and to show some type of stability and groundwork, it enables you to move forward to go to trade schools or maybe even go to college where you can get a job, thus creating income for yourself, thus keeping you off the streets, and so on and so forth. And it just it's also, like I said, a sign of hope, because people that don't want to do anything in life, they kind of don't have any hope, and it's sad. So what they did today, very courageous, very forward, and I wish them well, onward and up.
Why?
You gotta pay it forward. You know, somebody mentored me when I was growing up, you know, and unknowingly or knowingly, you mentor people all the time. You know, so you can unknowingly be mentoring somebody. So from people who, like you guys are doing the video, there's somebody watching you right now. It's like, I wanna do that. You're in a lightweight way mentoring them and you don't even know it. So by positive reinforcement, to add that positive reinforcement to talk to them, that only helps to encourage them more. I'm pretty sure that there are people that listen to me on the radio and say, hey, I want to do radio. If I get a chance to meet that person, I could tell them the ins and outs of radio, what to expect, what can be done, what they may not be able to do. So mentoring is very, very important. It's actually the solution to a lot of this violence out here in the neighborhoods, because growing up, we had older guys that we looked up to that even if they were going to be on some dirt, they sent us home because they know they didn't want us doing that. So we need to get back to that. So I think mentorship plays a very important role.
What do you feel is the most important lesson these graduates should take before into their life?
Don't take no for an answer. You're going to hear no a lot in your life. I've been doing radio now for 14, 15 years, and I've heard no numerous times. But always be ready for that one yes. Always be ready, because that one yes could be life-changing. You know, if you hear no, 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 and you start accepting no, one time there's going to be an opportunity for that yes to be there, but because you're so negative and you have no hope, which goes back to the GED and stuff, you're going to bypass that chance. Nose to the grindstone, nothing is easy, nothing in life is guaranteed. There's no such thing as luck in my book. Luck is when hard work meets opportunity. So if you work hard when that opportunity arises, it's not luck, that's meant for you. You're supposed to have that. So reach out and go get it, and stop waiting on people to give you stuff. So, you know, absolutely, you know, like, let's be honest, don't sugarcoat it. The world ain't safe, man. It's cold. It doesn't care about you. It keeps rotating, whether you're here or not. So you got to make it happen.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
Man, at the end of the day, man, I think communication is the key. We need to get back to talking to each other, man. Like, when did this become hello? And that's what it is now. You know, the nods, the head nods, the fist pumps and all that. Why can't we just say hello, good morning, how you doing? You'd be surprised how much of a difference that makes in a person's day, and it relieves tension. And I also think this, you know, men, we have to be leaders again. A lot of times I think our women in society don't look at us as leaders because we don't show pretty good leadership qualities doing a lot of the stuff that we do out here in the streets. So we need to get back to leading again. And get back to the village raising the children. Get back to where your mama or my mama could tell this child something and they honor it, because we as a community want to make sure everything's cool and not just letting the ne'er-do-wells and the bad guys overrun our community. Because at the end of the day, if we don't want it, why should somebody else want it for us? You know, if I don't want to do better for myself, why should all the pressure be on you to clean up my neighborhood when I'm going to just take a piece of paper and throw it back on the ground when I leave? So it falls back on us, the community. Let's make it happen. Let's get out here. Let's build, create, get our own money, and be nice to each other, man. Like, what's up? Like, you know, I guarantee you, if you hug one of these guys that got their pants hanging down by their waist, they wouldn't even know how to react. They wouldn't even know how to react to a nice word like, hey, brother, how you doing, man? Good to see you today. They don't know how to react because they're so used to people yelling at them and talking at them. So when you talk to them, they don't even know how to embrace it. Let's get back to embracing each other. Good morning. How you doing? How you feeling, man? You all right? You having a good day? And somebody may not be having a good day and be like, nah, I'm having a messed up day. Well, man, talk about it, bro. What's going on? Because you might have went through the same thing they're going through and you can help them get over it. Just be nice to each other.
I'm Jacob Carruthers. I'm the YESRSP mentor here at ASN Preparatory Institute.
So why is this day important to you?
Well, it's real important. It's our graduation day. We want to have the ceremony for our GED graduates. Let them know that their equivalency is just as important as their high school diploma is going to open up the same doors and get them the same opportunities. And we want them to know that their accomplishment is just as much of as an accomplishment if they had did it in high school, you know. So this is the second chance. A lot of people go through different things and couldn't make it through, and we provide this opportunity to the youth here in Chicago. So,
what was the most difficult thing about getting your students to this point in their life?
You know, people got a lot of outside influences and a lot of outside distractions, and just trying to keep them focused on their academic success. And sometimes, you know, when you're young, you don't see the importance of it, you know, especially if you didn't make it through high school and then you spent some time out of high school. Just trying to get them to understand the importance of it and how much of a priority it is. Sometimes that's a little challenge with young people. So, but you know, they made it through, so it's cool.
What role do you feel ASN is playing in
example, ASN was very, ASN doing what they have to do to get resources to help out-of-school youth and at-risk youth is very important in Chicago. So that's a very big help, just providing these resources and finding these resources and providing these resources to youth. So that's very important.
Why is education important to you?
Education is real important to me because it gives you the tools necessary to understand the world that you live in, and it gives you skills that you can't get without an education. So it's just certain doors that you want open and certain places that you want to go that you will not be able to get to without an education. So that's why it's very important. So, these ladies. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
They can just edit this out. These guys are pros. All right, so.
What is your favorite thing about today?
My favorite thing about today is just seeing how proud the mothers were and crying for their graduates and just, you know, just people, the students and the mothers feeling accomplished. You know, that was real important for me, so I really liked that.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
I'd just like to add that ASN Prep Institute is the best GED program in the whole Chicago. So if you got any youth between ages of 17 to 21 that's out of school, you need to send them down here as quick as possible. As you see, we get a graduation. It's no graduation fee, no fees for the pictures. We take them on college tours, we provide wraparound services, and we help put them on a career path. So this is one of the best, this is the best GED program in the whole state, I believe.
My name is Ayolani Stain. I am 18 years old, and I graduated from ASN Preparatory Institute.
And why is this day important to you?
Well, it's important because I didn't graduate my eighth grade year, but I did go on to high school, and I finally got to graduate. So it's important to me.
And what was the most difficult thing about getting to this point in your life?
Most difficult?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not quite sure.
Like staying on task, being in a school, or anything like that?
No, I stayed on task. And I got it done in like 2 months, so I don't know what the difficult part of it was.
Okay. What role did alternative schools have in getting to this point?
What rule?
What role?
Role?
Yeah.
My people tell them all about your mentor, Alani, all right?
Oh, okay. Him. He pushed me for it, but role. Can you repeat that again? I didn't really.
What role has alternative schools played in getting you to this point rather than like in regular high school?
Right, high school?
Yeah.
They push you forward. Yeah. I don't know what to say right now.
We should let you read over the questions so you have time to think about it.
Sure. Yeah, you want to? You want to?
No,
sure.
I'm good.
Okay. So why is education important to you?
Well, it should be important to everybody to get further in life, to know things, to have knowledge of things.
Some knowledge is bad.
Huh?
Some knowledge is bad.
Some, not all.
Hey, you guys, why don't you support if y'all want something?
All right, what are your plans for the future?
Oh, you can let everybody know.
My plans.
We can edit that out.
Okay. My plans for the future. I really want to do business management, but right now I don't really know what I want to do. It's either teaching, real estate, business management, whatever. But whatever I do, it affects my future. For right now.
Where do you see yourself in like 10 years from now?
Maybe in a house, probably in Arizona or Florida or California.
Husband and kids?
Yeah. Husband and kids.
What was your favorite thing about today?
Getting my diploma. Shout out to Ms. Smith for helping me, Mr. Jacob, Ms. Franklin, all the staffs, especially the teachers, because they broke down. Yeah.
Okay, I'm Pamela Jeffers. I'm a GED instructor for math and science.
So why is this day important?
This day is very important to me because I saw a lot of students achieve what they set out to do, and that was to complete the GED. It was a very challenging program, and a lot of students at first sight thought it was going to be really simple. But we spent numerous hours, especially in after-school tutoring, till sometimes 4 in the afternoon, helping them prepare. So to see that this was the end result and it was success, I'm very happy. Very pleased.
What were the most difficult challenges, I guess, that the students had to overcome?
Some of the most difficult challenges is the things that they already thought they knew and they had forgotten, and trying to get them to understand there was a basic skills section on the GED exam that really piggybacks from elementary, and they felt like it was an insult. And I had to reteach it, and they had to relearn it. And a lot of times they didn't want to do that. It was like, I did that a long time ago, and I'm like, but this is not that, you gotta do it. So we went back to the drawing board, fractions, improper fractions, decimals, all that great stuff, and it was a challenge for some of them. They had a great role of getting them established into, first of all, school mode. A lot of students had to get in the mindset that I'm in school, I'm here to learn. And then also the alternative school network also got them prepared for future, because it wasn't just be done with the program and sit at home. They had to have another destination. And so one of the things that was really great with this entire program, the students have another destination. Either they're going to be in trade school or college. Some of them have possibly thought about the military or working. So this is just the beginning.
Why is education important to you?
Education is the key to unlock many opportunities. In a fast-paced society that we're in, where we are dealing with intellect, the internet, logic, you can't do anything without it. And so a lot of students are learning that even if I don't want to go to college, I need some type of training, which is education. So we try to get them to understand you never stop learning, whether it's through formal education, whether it's on the street or at home, you never stop. My favorite part of today's ceremony was watching those two young ladies tell their story. They both had some very difficult obstacles to overcome, and one young lady, which you saw presented first, lost her father, and she had moments where she just didn't want to do it anymore, and to get her motivated, and then to see, wow, you did it. The other young lady, again, she had some health issues, and she was determined, I'm going to complete this program. She even took a leave of absence from her job. So that let me know then she was so serious, and then to see today, it happened. It was worth it. Yes. I think that Chicago and the surrounding suburbs need to know about the ASN Preparatory Institute. It's an excellent GED program where we work with students. The main thing is we don't just stop here. We get them ready with the ACT. We take them to college tours. We expose them to other opportunity in the workforce, because we're covering every ground. College isn't for everyone, but we want them to think about constantly their future and preparing for their future. So I think it's a hidden jewel that Chicago really don't know about. And we want to get the word out.
My name's Twan Harper. I'm 18 years old. I'm graduating from ASN Preparatory Institute.
Why is this day important to you?
Well, this day is very important because it symbolizes everything I strive for to achieve and every self-sacrifice that I made to get to the goal to get here as of where I'm at right now.
What was the most difficult thing about getting to this point in
The most difficult thing is the trials, the tribulations everybody else go through. You know, the same old thing. You know, it's everything we've already been through our lives, our individual paths that we go down that make us who we are. So we choose, you know, choose negative, we positive. So it's a negative, I mean positive outlook. So, you know.
What role do you feel alternative schools play?
I feel like they played the biggest role of all, you know what I'm saying? They care for me and they showed that extra love that other schools or other programs might have not shown. So at the end of the day, they play a very big, vital role.
All right. Why is education important to you?
Education is important because you don't want to be a dummy, period. Nobody wants to be a dummy, so yeah, don't be a dummy. Go to school, learn something, man. Take care of your family.
What are your future plans?
Future plans are to keep going to school, go further, you know what I'm saying? Keep going. I really want to learn how the man works. So psychology, I think that's right for me. So that's my next point.
Where do you see yourself in 5 to 10 years?
In 5 to 10 years, the next 5 years, I'll probably still be in school studying. In the next 10 years, I see myself trying to work on my personal life and build in my life. So, yeah. All right.
What was your favorite thing about today?
My favorite thing about today was just getting to see everybody, see my family, see my loved ones, see all my classmates, my teammates, all the mentors, to see everybody here, just everybody being here helping me, you know, helping me through this. Shout out to everybody that you know who you is. I ain't got to do all that, so, you know.
My name is Erica Williams. I'm the HR Generalist Director.
Why is this day important to you?
It's important because this is the second graduating class for ASN Prep, so it's building the foundation for our school to grow and to continue to help the community and the students or people who want to achieve their GED and become successful in life.
What role do you feel alternative schools have played in getting the students to this point?
I think it's given those students who don't feel comfortable in high school an outlet to achieve their high school diploma or GED needs.
Why is education important to you?
Education to me is important because education is the building block to your life. Education can get you to any place in the world, any occupation that you dream to do, and as students, as people, we need to dream big and outside the box. The graduation was great. The commencement speaker, Leon Rogers, hit several points that I feel that the students should hear and need to know, that just because you have a GED, that shouldn't stop you, and you should be complacent. That should motivate you to go towards higher goals, whether it's college or trade school or opening up a business. You don't have to, every college is not for everyone, but you need to find that niche that's going to allow you to be successful in your life. Okay, I'm done.
Is there anything else you want to say?
I just wish the graduates luck in their best years.